Happy New Year, everyone. Hello and welcome or welcome back to the Jean Made channel. I'm Paula Jean. This is where I share about some of my sewing and making endeavors. And I hope everybody had a lovely holiday season. I know that I did. And I hope the end of 2023 found you with friends and loved ones enjoying great food and festivities. Or if you opted for the peaceful solo holiday season, high five to you. I hope it was luxurious and amazing. This is part two of a little winter refashion mini-series that I'm doing. This was actually supposed to be my last video of 2023, but things got busy, plans went awry, as plans are wont to do. But my word for 2024 is acceptance, radical and otherwise. So I'm not going to waste time berating myself for not getting a video out when I wanted to, and I'm just going to move on with my life. And I hope you will join me. If you missed part one, where I turned an oversized flannel shirt into a short flannel shacket, I will leave the link to that video down below and you can watch that at your leisure. For this video, I am taking two spring summer dresses that don't fit me the way that I like anymore, and I'm going to turn them into separates. On that note, what I'm wearing today is a sweater that I refashioned from a dress several years ago. I took the skirt part of the dress and made these fabulous sleeves using the Somerset top pattern by Maven Patterns, and I'll leave that link down below as well. So let's get into dress number one.
This is a really cute wrap dress that I've worn to events and places that hold great memories for me. I love this abstract print that is in my colors, and the fabric is stretchy and comfortable. However, I've always been iffy about these short tulip sleeves on me, and I bought this when my proportions were different, so there's not really enough coverage in the front. That coupled with this odd length makes it very prone to wardrobe malfunctions. I also feel like these style lines don't really do the fabric justice. But when I turn it around, I really love this higher neckline, and the crossover in the back does cover my bra band. Obviously, if I was to keep this a dress, there would be some unwanted breezes going on back there, which is why I'm making it into a top. The sleeves aren't bad on this neckline, but I would like something longer since I want to wear this in cooler weather.
All right, I've got the dress backwards on Betty here, and here's how I see this going down. So obviously this would be choking me right now, and so I'm gonna wanna cut this down. I'll probably just use a t-shirt pattern as a guide and I'll cut that down to where it's comfortable. And I thought this neck edge was just folded over, but it turns out there is actually a knit binding here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna unstitch this from shoulder to shoulder and cut down to where I need right here, and it's not very much, so I think that I'm going to be able to reuse that facing because it is stretchy, and just reattach it to the neckline there. Hopefully that is as simple and easy as it is in my brain. So then I'm going to cut it off to top length, so I'm going to do that at the high hip here, and I think for the moment I'm going to cut it straight across at the back, but I also have a feeling that I'm going to end up curving that edge and kind of echo the original tulip shape at the bottom. I think that'll be cute in the back. And then for the sleeve, I really like the little gathers on the cap sleeve as it is, the little tulip cap sleeve here, but I do want to make this a longer sleeve garment. So I'm going to hopefully have enough fabric in the skirt part of the dress once I cut it off to make some just elbow length sleeves that, again, I'll probably use a t-shirt pattern for. And because I like these gathers, and rather than recreating them or trying to recreate them on another sleeve, I think I'm just going to try installing the straight sleeve at the same in the arm side. So it'll be a straight sleeve underneath that goes to the elbow, and then it'll have these little cap tulips over the top. And it might look weird, but I think it also might look kind of cool. So I'm gonna give it a shot. And hopefully that all works out exactly as I have planned.
After marking the neck and hemline, I started by cutting off the bottom, and I actually went ahead and cut off that curve at the back as well. I then detached the binding between the shoulder seams, freehanded the front neckline curve, and cut that off. I did run into an issue though, because once I matched up the centers, I realized that the binding actually did not have enough stretch for the new neckline. So I cut a new piece of binding from the leftover fabric that was about 90% of the new front neckline measurement, and I attached that to the original binding at the shoulders. I then matched up the shoulder seams and reattached the binding the same way as the original, and it actually blends in perfectly. Next, I used the sleeve pattern from the Len top by Laure Piar, folded at about elbow length, and cut two sleeves from the skirt fabric. Since these will be sewn as set-in sleeves, I serged the underarm first. After tucking in the tulip caps, I pinned in the Len sleeves and was so happy to find that it fit in with very little easing necessary. After serging the armholes, I decided to finish the sleeves with a cuff. I cut a piece about 5 inches wide, which once it was folded and stitched to the sleeve, gave me about a 2-inch cuff. I did a similar finish for the bottom hem, using the rest of the fabric to create a band that I tapered at the end where it meets the ties. I also created a little belt loop for the side waist and a strap at the upper back to keep it from opening too wide. And I'm actually kind of amazed at how well this turned out. I think the double sleeve is actually cute and subtle. I like the detail at the back, and the length of the sleeves works really well for me. The bottom band gives just a little bit of weight to that bottom hemline. And because I added that little belt loop at the side, I actually have some options as to how to tie it. When I tie it at the back, I actually get a really nice sleek look in the front. But no matter how it's tied, I think this design does the fabric so much more justice. On to dress number 2. So this looks like a nice, easy breezy knit slip dress. It's basic black, it's a midweight cotton jersey, it's a good midi length, and it has this really fun handkerchief hemline. However, the fabric has very low stretch and terrible recovery, so it's not supportive and not bra friendly. Plus, it doesn't have pockets. So I think the remedy is to cut it off under the bust, turn it into a skirt, and add some pockets. So that is the plan. After cutting off the bodice and marking the approximate pocket placement, I unpicked the side seams. Because it was sewn on a serger, I was a bit concerned with the fabric being weakened, so I cut some strips of fusible knit interfacing to support the pockets. I used some fairly robust lace for the pocket facings and a scrap of lightweight knit fabric for the pocket bags. I also added a little bit of height to accommodate how I'm going to finish the waist. I then sewed the pockets into the side seam and sewed the front to the back. And then basted the finished pocket edge to the waistline. I wanted a clean finish for the waist, so I decided to make a facing out of some leftover ponte. I took a very unceremonious approach to this by tracing out the waist of the skirt with some chalk. I'll be using 2-inch elastic, so I decided to make the facing 3 inches wide to make sure that I would cover it. After cutting it out and stitching it together, I finished just the bottom edge with some serging. I also cut out a loop of waistband elastic, just slightly smaller than the facing. I then attached the facing to the skirt, right sides together, and over that I layered the piece of elastic. I offset the elastic just a little bit so I would have a little bit of fabric that my serger could cut off cleanly. After that was all serged together, I could then flip everything to the inside, including the pieces of lint it collected along the way, and I now have a really nice, cleanly finished waistband. So so the elastic is now sandwiched in between the facing and the skirt. And to make sure it doesn't flip up, I went ahead and stitched in the ditch at the side seams. And now I have this multi-season, twirl-worthy basic skirt with a comfortable waist and pockets. I didn't realize it would have a bit of a boho vibe, but I quite like it.
So that's a wrap on my winter refashions so far. I've got some exciting stuff, well, for me anyway, coming up. I'm going to be doing a pattern test for a much-loved pattern designer here on YouTube. And I've got some home decoration stuff that I really want to focus on this year, and I'll be sharing that on here. I really want to give a heartfelt thank you to everybody who has subscribed or commented or liked my videos. I'm going to be coming up on my 1 year YouTube anniversary here in a month and a half or so. I really truly appreciate everybody's support, and I would love to grow this channel this year. So if you're watching this and you like the content, or you know somebody who you think might like it, please consider subscribing or sharing or giving that thumbs up or leaving a comment so that other people in the YouTubeverse can find me. In the meantime, I wish everybody a wonderful 2024. I hope you get the rest and relief and peace that you may be looking for, that maybe 2023 was missing for you. And I will see you next time.